everyone. So today, we will learn something new. We will learn a poem, and the title is, as you can see on the screen,
The Meal. Okay. The Meal is actually a poem that I adapted from the poem The Meal by Carla Kaskin. So, okay, now look at the poster there. Okay, the poster there. As you can see, there's a boy with blonde hair is eating. So you can look at the picture there. Imagine, what do you think he actually eat?
So the poem, The Meal, is talking about what does the boy eat. Alright, so are you curious what did he eat? So let's go.
So the poem, The Meal, is talking about what does the boy eat. Alright, so are you curious what did he eat? So let's go. We will read it. Alright, so this is the poem. It has four stanzas there. And then, shall we read it together? Okay, I will read it. Okay, so when I read it, you must follow after me. Alright? The Meal. Tonny Tompkins had turnips and tea. The turnips were tiny. He ate at least three. Good. And then for dessert, he had onions and ice. He liked them so much that he ordered it twice. He had 2 cups of ketchup, a prune, and a pickle. Delicious, said Tonny. Well, worth a nickel. He folded his napkin and, happy to add, it's one of the loveliest breakfasts I have had.
Alright. So this is the poem. Alright. I hope you read it with exactly like how I read it. The pronunciation, the tone, and the mood and everything, alright? Okay, so now let's check it out. Let's try to understand the poem by stanzas, alright?
Okay, stanza 1. Okay, the first stanza. Tonny Tompkins had turnips and tea. The turnips were tiny. He ate at least three. Okay, what is actually turnips? What is turnip? Okay, look at the picture here. This is turnip. Okay, I'm sure it's not that familiar with what is turnip, but turnip is a large, round, pale vegetable that grows under the ground. Okay, as you can see here, look at the picture here. This purplish whitish thing, vegetable is called turnip. You ate this part, but you don't take the green part of the turnips. Okay, alright, so turnips actually taste like a bit like radish, but not really like radish. It's similar, it has a similar taste with radish, so it's not really a good meal to eat at the very first place. And then Tonny Tompkins also had tea, alright? I'm sure you know what is tea mean, okay? Tea, alright? Normal tea, not added with milk, alright? Teh-o is tea, understand? Alright, very good. And then Tonny actually eats the turnips tree, okay? Remember that turnips are actually large, but because the turnips is small size, Tony ate three at least. It means that he actually ate a lot. Right, so let's go to the second stanza. Second stanza. And then for dessert, he had onions and ice. He liked them so much that he ordered it twice. Huh, look at that. Dessert. What does it mean by dessert? Huh, dessert. Okay, dessert are usually small meals. I mean, small meal or a mini meal that you ate after you ate your main meal. Okay, for example, during lunchtime, you ate rice with chicken, vegetable, and what else in one plate. So that is your main meal. But for dessert, you eat dessert after you eat your rice, your vegetable, and your chicken. For example, for dessert, usually people eat, for example, ice cream, pudding, cake, what else?
Okay, for example, during lunchtime, you ate rice with chicken, vegetable, and what else in one plate. So that is your main meal. But for dessert, you eat dessert after you eat your rice, your vegetable, and your chicken. For example, for dessert, usually people eat, for example, ice cream, pudding, cake, what else? So, as for Tony, he ate dessert. Look at what kind of food he ate.
Onions! Alright, girls and boys, Tony eat onions for dessert. And also ice. Onions and ice. He even liked onions and ice that he ordered it twice. Okay, order here means to request for something, such as food or goods such as things. To be made, supply, or deliver. Okay.
For example, in sentence, you go to the restaurant, you want to eat roti canai. Okay, so you say, I want to order roti canai. Okay, so order means actually Tony requests to Tony requests to for the restaurant to make him onions and ice. One more. So Tony ate two times. Onions and ice. Right, let's go to the next sentence.
Stanza 3. He had 2 cups of ketchup, a prune, and a pickle. Delicious, said Tony. Well, worth a nickel. Okay, what is ketchup? Girls and boys, look at what Tony ate. Ketchup. 2 cups of ketchup. Look at here, ketchup. Yes, ketchup is, if it's in Malaysia, we call it tomato sauce, right? But if it's in Western countries such as US, United States of America, United Kingdom, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, and such, they call tomato sauce as ketchup. Alright? Ketchup, not ketchup. Ketchup is different. Ketchup in our country is soy sauce, right? Soy sauce. But in their country, ketchup is actually tomato sauce. Okay. Tomato sauce. A prune. Here, a prune here. And a pickle. Okay, as you can see, prune is actually dried plum. Plum is a fruit. Plum? See plum? Yeah. Plum is a fruit. And when they dry the plum, it becomes prune. Look at here. I'm sure you know this. You have seen this in supermarket or anywhere. You have seen this brand before. And then pickle. Pickle is preserved vegetable or fruit in vinegar or salty water. Okay, so any vegetable or fruit that they preserve using vinegar, salty water is called pickle. But for these Western people, when we mention pickle, usually they use cucumber. Like in their sandwich, we put a normal cucumber, right? But for the Western people, they put pickled cucumber in their sandwich.
Okay, so what are the other example of pickle? Other example of pickle is guava pickle, Mango pickle, lime pickle, what else? There's a lot actually. Kedondong and everything. You can ask your mom. Usually, your mom and dad, okay. You can ask your mom and dad, or your sister or your brother, or anyone, your grandpa, your grandma, what are the other examples of pickle? Because I am sure they know what is pickle. In Malaysia, there's a lot of types of pickle.
Alright, and then what about nickel? Well, worth a nickel. A nickel is actually a US, United States of America, or Canadian coin worth 5 cents. Okay, it's actually 5 cents, but it's in US or Canada. Okay, one nickel costs you 5 cents. Understand? Alright, answer 4. He folded his napkin, and happy to add, it's one of the loveliest breakfasts I have had. Okay, so that's the last answer. So, he folded his napkin. Okay, folded here means, look at the GIF here. It is when you bend something into smaller shapes and sizes. For example,
alright, for example, I'll show you a real life example. You are folding the paper. Folding. Another one, folding into smaller shapes and sizes. So this is cool. And how about napkin? Okay, napkin here.
The man is folding a napkin. And how about Winnie the Pooh? The Winnie the Pooh is also wearing a napkin when he's about to eat. Alright, so that's it. And Tonny said, Tonny, after eating, he folded his napkin. Folded his napkin and said, wow, it's one of the loveliest breakfasts I have had. So that is the end of the poem. Alright. Now, just a simple game to test. Do you understand or not? Alright, so try to find where are the three turnips. Okay, so where are the three turnips? Okay, here, one turnips, two turnips, three turnips. Okay, very good. Okay, how about tea? Which one is the tea? Yes, exactly. Tea is here. Tea is in the one that he is holding. Onions? Where is onions? Alright, very good. These are the onions. The onions are on top of the ice. Yes, very good. The onions are on top of the ice. And the ice are in the bowl, in the red bowl. Okay, how about ketchups? 2 cups of ketchup. Okay, the ketchups are here. Here, 1 and 2. Alright, very good. How about a prune and a pickle? Okay, which one on the plate? Okay, this one, these two are turnips. Okay, which one on the plate are prune and which one is a pickle? Have a guess.
I won't tell you the answer because I'm sure you will know which one is prune, which one is pickle, because your friend is able to guess it correctly. So I'm sure you guess it correctly based on what I have told you before. Okay? Alright, let's continue.
Okay. Right, now it's time for you to read the poem with emotions. Okay. Take note that I wrote there as emotions, not emotion. Okay, what kind of emotions is that? Alright, read the poem in different emotions. Okay, here I have 4 emotions. Normal, happy, angry, and sad. Okay, what you're going to do now is try to read the poem according to these emotions. Here you have to read it in a normal way, like how you are supposed to read a poem. Next one is happy. Third one is angry. And last one is sad. Okay, because I have done this with your classmates, because I have done it with your friends, I will insert a video of how your friends read the poem. Okay, so let's watch how your friends read the poem with me. Let's go. You follow after me, okay?
Okay.
All right, the first one is normal feeling, like how you're supposed to read a poem. Okay, the meal. The meal. Follow after me, everyone. You can open your mic. The meal.
The meal.
Tonny Tompkins had turnips and tea.
Tonny
Tompkins had
turnips and tea.
The turnips were tiny.
Were tiny.
Okay. He ate at least three.
At least three.
Okay, very good. Now it's happy time. Okay, make yourself happy. Even though probably you did not feel happy right now, but try to make yourself feel happy. Happy, okay? Right.
And then.
Hey, who's that? That's not happy tone.
And then.
For dessert. He had onions.
And ice.
He liked them so much. Okay, I actually heard one person with no tone, okay? That he ordered it twice. Ah, Damia, I heard you didn't read it properly, but never mind. Now it's time for angry. Okay, get yourself into angry mode. Angry. Okay, think about angry things. Okay, angry things.
Okay.
You are angry right now. You are angry. I'm also angry. Damia, he had two cups.
He had two cups of ketchup.
A prune and a pickle. Okay, this is funny. Angry. Delicious. Say, Tony. Well, what a nickel. Okay, alright. Now you're angry. Now, change your emotion into sad. Okay, sad. So sad. I haven't eaten my breakfast today. Lapanya. Okay, sad. Right now, sad. He folded. Hey guys, repeat after me. He folded his napkin and happy to add
it's one of the
Okay, who is that with normal tone? Okay. Love you, yes, breakfast.
I have had.
Okay, very good to everyone. Good job.
Alright, now, it was kind of funny, right? I know it's funny. But, yeah, that's how the activity goes. It's fun. So, now, I want you... Okay, I give you 30 seconds to read the poem on your own. Alright, read it, try to understand it. Okay, if you suddenly do not understand, you can go back from where, whichever part that you do not understand, and watch and listen again. Okay, alright, once you're done your 30 seconds, you can continue the video. Alright.
Alright, if you have understand the poem, let's play Kahoot, alright? Waiting for the Kahoot. Ready, get set, Kahoot! Okay, so now, There are 8 questions for you to answer this Kahoot, and the challenge ends until Sunday night. So you still have time for you to do it again. So because 6 of your friends, no, actually 5 of your friends have played this. So as usual, write down your short name with your class in here. Okay, and then you can click go. All right. Okay.
Very good. The questions is based on the poem that we have learned. So you can think carefully and answer each of it based on your understanding. Okay. All right.
Now, after you play Kahoot, what do you think we'll be going to? What do you think we will do next? Okay. Very good. You know it very well. It's homework time. Okay, for your homework, remember that last night I asked you to do what? Remember that I give you this mission? I'm sure you remember it. Dear boys and girls, before we start our class tomorrow, I have a mission for you. List out any food or drinks or cooking ingredients that you can find in your house that follows these syllable rules. Okay, what is syllable rules? Syllable is the sound in a word. Here's the example. For example, the word is car, and car has one syllable because it has one sound. Cars, still one syllable because it's cars. Baby
is 2 syllables because baby. Teachers. Aeroplane. 3 syllables. Submarine. There are 3 sounds, so it has 3 syllables there.
So that is how you know what is syllable. I asked you to find 3 food or drinks or any ingredients that has 1 syllable, and 4 food or drinks or ingredients that has 2 syllables, right? I asked you last night. I hope you actually do it beforehand. So if you haven't done it yet, you can do it now before you start the homework. This is important. It's really related. Okay, now. Next. If you've done it, very good. So now, this is the homework. Recreate the poem with your own ingredients. That's why I asked you to prepare your own ingredients beforehand. Okay, how to recreate it? Use the ingredients. Match the food that Tonny Tompkins had in his meal with your ingredients that you have searched for my mission last night. That's the usage of the mission. Okay, you have to recreate the poem, but with your own ingredients. Write your poem in an A4 paper or exam sheet and decorate the poem creatively. Alright, after you have matched the words, you need to write the poem. Write the poem, okay? Full version, okay? Change the ingredients and write the poem. And after that, you decorate your work creatively, okay? Alright. Take a photo and send it to me on my WhatsApp. And then you need to send your homework by Sunday night, 10 p.m.
I repeat again, Sunday night, 10 p.m. Okay? Understand? Alright, so probably you are a bit clueless on how to do it. So here's an example, but you cannot copy my example, all right? So if you actually copy my work, copy my example, I will ask you to do it again.
Right, so for example, I actually chose fries, cake, milk.
Fries, cake, milk. It's 1 syllable. And then 2 syllables, cabbage, pepper, donuts, honey. So there are 2 syllables. I choose all of this. So what did I do?
I changed the whole poem here, the underlined words, with my own ingredients. Donuts, milk. Before this, it goes with Tonny Tompkins had turnips and tea, right? But I changed it to Tonny Tompkins had donuts and milk. Alright, so you change all the ingredients that I underlined here, here, and here, 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 and then change it with your own ingredients. And then, if you want to change the name, you can change the name too. For example, here, Tonny Tompkins, change your any kind of name that you want, probably your own name or other people's name or your favorite celebrity or your mentor or any people that you look out for, anything, okay, with your own. You can change it. And then remember, if because this poem, the Tony is a boy, so they use he. Where else? He, his. So if you use a woman or if you use a female name, you need to make, you need, must change it to female. You must change it to female, all right? For example, the name is, Meili. Meili is a girl. So change it to she ate at least three. And then for dessert, she had blah 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 blah. She liked blah blah blah. Okay, remember to change it. Okay, if it's wrong, I will ask you to do correction again. All right. That's all for today's class. I hope you enjoy today's class about poem.
See you next time.